Hello again, and welcome again in Belgium. It's nighttime. I like nighttime. My dragon prefers daytime, but that is what makes us one. What I want to tell you about is actually not very much about your path of the dragon. It is more for the people who don't believe in dragons. And to me, it's fine that you don't believe in dragons. I don't care if you don't believe or if you believe. If you believe, it's fine. I will help you as a brother. You are my brother and sister. If you believe in them, if you think that the dragon is with you and inside of you, I will help you with this. None of our paths are the same, but I will try to find a way to help you. All the time. That is a rule for me as a follower of the dragon, as a draconic Wiccan, and which I will help you. But for people who don't believe in dragons, I have this message. Don't see these people as someone crazy. They are not. They just believe in something that you don't feel, and that is not a shame, because look at Christianity. There's a church in the middle of this town. Every town has it. And everyone just accepts this. And even though this church suppresses many people, they still accept this. But this path of the dragon is not a suppressive spirituality. It's not even a religion. It's when you feel it, it remains inside of you. If someone else is feeling it, then you can conversate to each other and find similarities to help each other. We are not suppressing anyone. This is just our faith, and we only ask a bit of respect for the one who believes in a dragon. We feel things that you don't, and you just, the only thing, we don't ask you to believe. We only ask you to have respect. Have respect for our faith. Our faith is not easy. It comes from a suppressive time, when everyone was told that dragons were evil, and later on the dragons were not even real. Even though we cannot find evidence for the existence of the dragon, we believed in them because we can feel them. And that is the only thing. The only thing that is not that difficult is to show some respect for what we believe. And I know if someone asks me, I believe in unicorns, then I say, okay, that's fine by me. But it's not my path. My path is somewhere else. I mean, if Jesus can resurrect in 3 days from the dead, that is difficult to believe, and yet so many people believe that. So what is so difficult about dragons? They are just creatures of the old, like the dragons were from ancient times when the dinosaurs were here. In fact, the dragon is like a dinosaur. Just look at them, they are giant reptiles, born out of wisdom, born out of the elements of nature. That is not that difficult. God for us is nature. God and God is together. They create life. And the dragon is their guardian. Is that so difficult to have respect for? If someone believes that, if they can feel the dragon, to work for the light just like them. They have a purpose here. They have a purpose to be with us. That is not so difficult. Just don't listen to people who just ridicule all that they don't understand. Because when people don't understand, they just ridicule everything. And I'm sick of it. Just listen to yourself. Just listen to the theory of the one who believes in the dragon. And just make up your mind later on. That is the only thing that we ask from people who don't believe in dragons. And it's these people are with like 90% of the earth population of humans that don't believe in dragons, that don't feel the dragon. And that's fine. We don't care. Just have respect for our faith. That is everything that you need to do.